Dat gaan ze voor ons spelen. Ik zou zeggen, allemaal heel veel plezier. En Christian, kort oh ja, en als je hier staat, dan is het heel fijn als ook die voorste rijen een beetje bezet zijn. Dus als er iemand denkt van ik wil het allemaal heel goed zien en horen, dan zou ik naar voren komen.
Er zitten sportjes die kan niet verder. Ik wist ook niet meer. Die muzikanten vonden het zo goed, hebben net gevraagd.
Good luck. Thank you for being here.
Okay.
We are so happy. Thanks to Viola and Ben to receive us. And it's very special to play to you. We are so far of our country in South America, so thank you to be here. Jose on the guitar, on the acoustic guitar. Come on, we need your help. So it's very, we feel very emotional when we hear you playing Violeta Parra, Gracias a la Vida, Run Run. So today in Chile we are celebrating 99 years from Violeta Parra died. It's an anniversary now. So you can imagine it's very special to play to you Violeta Parra now in harmonica. So we'll play Gracias a la Vida. Thank you. thank you so much. Well, I should talk about the song and the song that you are practicing. You have been practicing around 1 or 2 weeks, I think so. Do you have any questions? So first, to talk about something here. No questions? Awesome. We can try to play together, no? With the intro, with this part. Okay? Are you ready? Two intros, right? You have two intros in the paper? Okay, let's try with the first intro. In my playing, I try to do the vibrato in the final of the songs. So I'm trying always to emulate the voice. This is Gracias a la Vida, you have lyrics, of course. So always I'm trying to emulate when, if you sing, in the final of the sound, when you listen a singer, always it's like a vibrato in the final. So in my playing, always I'm trying to emulate that. Because it's common to find the harmonica players that play like a vibrato all the time. Well, it depends on your playing, but in these songs, I'm always trying to emulate and to keep the motion of the song. So let's try again, and let's try to in the final to do like a little vibrato. Let's try with the intro again. We can continue to the second intro, okay? Let's see. We will try with the first intro, and then we will continue with the second intro. Okay. So. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. perfect. It's perfect, thank you. So, for the diatonic harmonica players, who is playing that diatonic in this song? Okay, so the most difficult part in that intro, I think, is to keep the sixth draw pending, maybe, and the three draw pending in the final. So what I'm doing is to do like a little vibrato in the bending, and maybe to put more energy, more power in that bending. The note before that bending is an A, in A, it's a sixth row. I'm not playing the vibrato in the sixth row, so I'm playing the vibrato in the bending. You can try it. Just play the sixth row and the bending. I think for the chromatic harmonica players, should be the same, so... Let's try that two notes. Yeah? One, two, three, four. My face, this is, I think it's, this is going back, I think of. To be dependent. And the vibrato, I'm making yo. Not so strong for my belly. Not so strong. This vibrato I'm making from yo. Let's try again. One, two, three, four. I think maybe it could be a good exercise to practice the bend. Okay. For the chromatic harmonica players, maybe it should be the same. Maybe making the vibrato in the final note. In the final note. Okay, let's try with the second intro. Yeah. Maybe the bass. You can. Please put your hand for our bass. Please feel free if you have questions for us. Eh? Please, no question until now. Maybe just to practice, and it's really important. It's really important to be in tune, because we are playing an A flat in that final note. So maybe we can play A flat and A, you know, like that. Just to practice and to get a good sound in the bending. Okay, let's try with the second intro. The second intro. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. The other difficult part, I think, for the diatonic harmonica players is the one when we do. Okay, 4 blow, 3 draw, and the second bending is A, and you got 3 hold. Can we try? Da-da-da. Let's try all together, and we will keep the final note. Just try to be in tune. In tune. 3, 4.
Let's continue with the song.
4, 2, 3. Okay, let's do it again, let's do it. The lyrics say, gracias a la vida. So, pa, 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 da, gracias a la vida. Okay, these are the notes, you know. So the lyrics say, gracias a la vida. Okay, so I'm playing five, five, roll, five, roll. I'm the seventh row, in the diatonic. So F, 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 E, B. But in the CD or on the song, I'm playing the octaves. So now I'm playing the octave in the. So I'm playing two draw and five draw. It's not the same note, no? Yeah, and then I'm playing the three draw and seven draw. Seven draws, so I'm covering three holes in the diatonic. Okay, that's what I'm doing there. Okay, so. But I'm playing like a, of course I'm playing with my tongue, and I'm going to the notes with a technique that is called a slap. Slap, are you here? I'm playing three draw, seven draw, but I'm playing all the notes, and then I'm putting my tongue. So that's the technique that I'm doing there. Okay. I think it's up to you if you want to do that. No, it's maybe if you play just a melody, you can play gracias a la vida, five 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 draw, three draw. Instead of seven draws. You can try. Gracias a la vida. If you don't play with octaves, the right way to play that melody is 5, 5, 5, draw, 5, 5, blow, 5, blow, 5, draw, and 3, draw. That's the best way to play if you don't play with octaves. Because it's a lot similar to the voice. Okay? So let's try with that part, and we will continue to play. Okay? Gracias a la vida. I will count three. One, two, three. Gracias a la vida. Okay, let's try again. We will continue with this one. Very good. So any question? You have any questions? No questions? Five blow, and I'm playing the octave there, so I'm playing the two draw. So the two draw, just two draw and five draw. Two and five blow, sorry. And then two draw and five draw. But in the diatonic, if I'm playing two draw And 5 Pro is not an octave. Not an octave. So for that reason, it's that song. And then after that, I'm playing 3 Pro and 7 Pro. Is the octave of B, the note B. So I'm playing. So I'm making a little vibrato there. So it's like a... It's like a tremolo, I think so. It's tremolo, no, like a, I'm not changing the pitch of the note, so I'm just put the note very fast. It's like I'm playing... That's the kind of vibrato or tremolo that I'm doing there. Okay, so that's what I'm doing there. So if you don't play with octaves, you just can play. I think that's the best way to play that because it's the same melody that the voice is the same. Another question? Okay, let's play from the intro to the B part. And then the B part is, we need to play two times the B part. Huh? Please put your hand for Jose on the acoustic guitar. I know if you want to change the guitar for the harmonica. Hey. Song, and maybe you can do many things with that. You... when we make this CD with Jose, of course we didn't have any cap or nothing about the song, so we say, oh, okay, we need to do a Chilean folk. We want to do an album with Chilean music, so we hear the song, and I try to emulate the voice. That's all. So you can do the same, I think. Any question about the song? No?
Is this song standing on your CD?
Yeah, it's in the CD. Yeah. Gracias a la vida. What's that mean? Thanks for the life. It's a very famous song in Latin America, in the world. You can find many versions from different artists.
Violeta Parra is a songwriter that existed in the 50s and the 60s in Latin America. She traveled a lot through Latin America, you know, trying to get the traditional music from each country in South America. And she did like 3 or 2 records in the 60s. And this song was in 1966. Was that her last? Last album, which he died in 67. So this story, well, Gracias a la Vida means, you know, thanks to life. So it's, if you can see the, you can check the lyrics in YouTube and in the internet, and you see what she means about it. And she, well, she's got really, there's another song that you guys, I think you play in Run Run, and it's a very nice tune as well, and it talks about life as well, you know, love. So, Yeah, she's. This song has been in many languages. So, well, she did it in English, Chile, South America. Well, for us, it's really nice to see you guys. Yeah, we feel like home. Yeah. These songs, you know, it's my mom used to play the guitar with that as well. So it's like really, you know, into the family as well. Get it for the teeth over there. Got that.
Please for Viola, he's all of this is thank you Viola. It's amazing the work that she's doing is amazing. It's amazing. Viola is the right.
Left here.
Ah,
I see it. Yeah, that's the same
camera.
Of daar niet voor
willen gaan zitten. So we will continue with room. What do you think? Yeah. I think we have kind of the same. Because I'm playing the same harp, the C harp, the diatonic. I think that the most difficult part is to keep the three bending, the same gracias a la vida. Let's start playing all together. It's a very relaxed song. In the beginning. Song? No?
We start from the beginning.
should be the, should be this. I'm not paying so much the three bending. Like that. I'm touching the, a little the three bend, but I'm caring to be in tune, but just a little, no, not to put a little a strong accent in the bending. One, two, three, four. You can start with the A minor, right? You can start whatever. You take your time to start. Okay, I'll play just with the section rhythm. I will play, and when I finish, just try to start, but take your time.
You can look at each other.
Keep them long. In the final, be proud in the final. Okay. Listen for the rhythm. It's good to have a space there, a silent. Start to sing. So the first part, when we wait for the rhythm section, and we start. That's the part that when Violeta sing. So it's not the same. We won't finish with the sixth row, the same, that part. So just in the intro. Okay. Let's practice the B part. Dun, 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 dun. is it starting? 1, 2, 3, 4. Ba 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 ba. Let's complete the B part. Let's try all the song until that part, from the beginning.
The song, she doesn't go faster. The bass part.
One, two, three.